5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, 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 and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X, for take two of my sensor tutorial, because when I came to upload the VOD, part of the actual broadcast was scrambled. There was a lot of artifacting on it, and it looked bad, so I think there were some problems with the stream. So I'm going to re-record it. It's probably going to be shorter, but not a problem. I still have the rover that I built during it, or rather, still have the sensor system that I put on during it, and so on. I've turned it off for now. So, anyway, to recap, this is the Chonky rover. This was built for Pertum's gravity, not Earth gravity, so it is somewhat not set up for this planet, so it does bounce a little. Here, however, is a sensor. So to make this system, which is basically a automatic parking brake system, turns the parking brake on, stops the rover dead if another player enters the field, we're going to need to do one of two things. Or rather, we're going to need to, first of all, pop to the info tab. And we want to show sensor field range. And then we want to go to our sensor. Now make sure you've placed the sensor correctly, which is the bar at the bottom and the blue circle at the top. And we want to go to the sensor, and all we need is show on HUD. And then we want to turn the block on. Now, there is our sensor, and that's our field. I'll run the numbers. They will be different for you, but that's all right. You can adjust them from within the sensor. Now, when I enter the sensor field as a player, it's going to sound this klaxon while I'm in the field. That's all right. What we want to do is we want to look at a 5 meter left extent for this rover, a 5 meter right extent, a bottom of 2.3, a top of 1. And as you adjust these, you'll see, if you look carefully, it will change. As you tap the A button as well, you can also put the value in using a more accurate slider. And if you tap it again, you can type the value in. So that can be done on any slider in the game as well. Makes it a lot easier to get the value you're looking for. We wanted a back extent of 15 meters to cover the back of the rover, and a front of about 8. We want it to detect players, but we don't want to change any of the other settings at the moment. You can fiddle around with that. TR's content. As you can hear, the klaxon is sounding because I'm standing in the way, and the parking brake on this rover, if you jump in, needs to be reset to... I'll give you a demonstration of it before I show you the rest of it. There you go. Now, I can't move this rover unless I manually engage the parking brake. It's very hard to move because there's another player in the way, but if I do that, but I'll need to reset that. So once again, if I pull forwards, you'll see that as long as there's a player there, this thing won't move. If you need to, press the parking brake on the Y button, but then toggle it again so you can make sure you can move, otherwise your system won't work properly. Anyway, so here we go. What we want to do, first of all, is access our sensor. We're going to set up the things that we need. What we need built on this is a sound block. I put that at the back, and two timer blocks. So the first timer block is set up with a delay of 1 second. Regardless. And you want the action on this to be industrial cockpit 5, park on off, and sound block play. Or in the case of you, whatever your industrial or cockpit is, go to your industrial cockpit or whatever it is, choose park on off, go to your sound block, and choose play. Now on our sound block, we have nothing changed. We have a 30 minute loop timer, and we picked out of all the sounds alert one. See, there's a lot of sounds. And now we've got our sound and a 30 minute loop timer. What we want now is to set up our timer block 2. 1 second delay, the same. Parking brake on off and sound block stop. Then you want to go to your actions on your sensor. See them there. Make sure all of your settings are correct. You haven't accidentally altered them. Go to setup actions. Go down to your timer blocks. Go to your first timer block here and hit trigger now. You want your second timer block. I'll clear them so you can see how it works. So timer block 1, trigger now. Then without leaving this menu, go to the second timer block, trigger now. That will set your system up. So your sensor will detect players in that field, turn the klaxon on, and then off the parking brake. Same deal, if you enter any of the field, it will turn on the parking brake. As long as I've got things set. Notice I've left the field because I'm in the cockpit. But if we head towards my other player, parking brake will come on and the rover will come to a stop. It will sound the klaxon. And until that player moves, so. And if you're wondering how I'm doing that, go and watch my replay tool tutorial. Show you how to use it and how to add and change characters. You'll see that I can move the rover again because the player has moved out of the sensor field. And say my first recording of this didn't work very well, so rather than leave you with no video, I've re-recorded the entire thing, which will be significantly shorter. However, there you go. That is your system. I'll recap it for you as I let's just move this. There we go. The klaxon up. So we need three things to begin with: a sensor, two timer blocks, and the fourth thing, the sound block. So in total, four blocks: one sensor, two timer blocks, one sound block. In your control panel, make sure you've got your sensor field on. You need to show it on HUD. You also need to make sure that in the info you have to show sensor field range, otherwise it won't show up. Then you want to set up your extents. You don't have to set them up like I do. Just make sure that you can set them up so a player will trigger the sensor. Leave everything here as it is, because it will work fine as is. And then what you're going to need to do on your setup actions just to begin with, timer block and timer block two. On the entry part of the field, we trigger the first timer block. On the exit, we trigger the second. Then you make sure your sound block is set up, wherever that is in your list, and it should be around there. Make sure you've got your sound block set. Make sure you've got your actual sounds themselves. Pick the alert sound, basically. Set the loop time to 30 minutes. There's a lot of things you could use, but stick to the alert sound. Then your first timer block, a delay of 1 second. Your action should be to turn your park on off and start playing the sound. Your second timer block, the same deal, 1 second. Park brake on off, stop playing the sound. And that's it. That's all you need to be able to make a system that stops the rover dead and sends an emergency klaxon while a player is standing in that field. There it is. That's your emergency parking brake system for a rover. So you shouldn't have to worry about accidentally running your friends over. Unless you want to accidentally run your friends over, of course, in which case it's not really an accident. Okay. Anyway, I will be back again with another tutorial and a few things. I'm working on a little experiment at the moment. As I am wont to do, I do sometimes like to show off and demonstrate things. If you haven't picked it up already, grab the Heavy Industry pack and watch my showcase video on both the free part of the update and the paid DLC, because honestly these electromagnets are pretty cool, especially the large grid one makes for a great landing gear, but also as is this little device here, or this thing, is my test drone for basically using an autopilot to take it to a location, but then the autopilot will turn off, and rather than landing at a set of coordinates using the autopilot, it's going to allow the drone to drop down and use modulated thrusters to bring it safely to the ground. It's still in progress. I'm still ironing out a few things here and there. It's working fairly well. Sometimes it lands a little heavily, but it doesn't actually damage the landing gear. So far so good. When I'm happy with it, I'll throw a tutorial up. And that means you might be able to use that to help you construct an actual automatic landing system for a ship. Although I suggest parachutes as well, just in case things go wrong. And as always, you can quick save by holding both bumpers down and tapping X. My advice is not to quick save while you're attempting to use the landing system. This thing is basically a working prototype. Look, if I take it up to a few hundred feet, let's say 300 and some odd, it will hover, and then if I activate the landing system, it starts to fall slowly but surely towards the ground. Give you a bit of a demonstration of it. This is not using an autopilot. This is just using modulated thrusters. The idea would be to use autopilot to take it out into space, move it to a set of coordinates where you can get the cargo from it. Then have the system. There you go. Bit of a heavy landing, but as you notice, landing gear fine. All well and good. Automated landing system kind of works. I'd like it to come down smoother, but it may not. As you can see, it modulates 8 thrusters at the bottom. I could probably add more thrusters to that. That might bring it down slower. Probably would. And there you go. That is a little demo of one of the things I'm working on. Hopefully you've enjoyed this. I've enjoyed doing it. I enjoyed doing the first one, but I was very sad when the footage didn't quite work, because that did show some troubleshooting steps and what can happen with space engineers when you're playing around with sensors. What went wrong with the build? Well, one of the things was that the second timer block was on a 10-second delay rather than a 1, and that threw the whole thing out. But that can happen. That's space engineers for you. If you've played it for any length of time, you know what I'm talking about. However, that's all I've got for now. So I will say, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Warfare 2 is on the way. I don't know when. And I don't know what's in it, but I'm looking forward to the whole thing. Bye for now.